sit here and let my car fall.
Well, that's not doing anything except probably damaging my windshield wipers.
I used to have an ice scraper,
but I couldn't find it in the trunk. So I don't know where it is or if I even still have it. Cause I used to live in New York. It's 34 degrees in Florida. We're not even in North Florida. We're like, it doesn't get cold here. Yet it is 34 degrees right now. I think I'm gonna go outside and speed up this progress a little bit. Good enough. I can drive now. Oh, frack. I forgot. I can't see out the back. The window's down. I can't see out my back window, which is kind of dangerous. I don't go to a gym. Like, all three of the places I go throughout the week to work out, none of them have, like, AC or heat. Hello everyone and welcome to another video. We are gonna go through a week of workouts or lifting for me. The week that this was filmed was about 4 to 5 weeks into a lifting cycle and about 4 to 5 weeks until my next weightlifting meet. So if you enjoyed this video in Olympic weightlifting, go ahead and subscribe so you can follow me on my weightlifting journey. Before I get into my workouts, I just want to say that I do not make any of my own programming. I work remotely with an Olympic weightlifting coach who creates the program. I meet with him once a week and send him videos of the rest of the week. The accessory work I do is a mix of suggested target areas, and then I get to pick what exercise or movement I want to do from that. I also add other things occasionally depending on how I feel each day. On this day in particular, it was freezing, so I did take my time warming up for these front squats. I worked up to about 80% of my one rep max, which is around 73 kilos or 160 pounds. I actually think I did 165 pounds because it was easier just to put on the weight that way. Sometimes I do that for convenience, I round up. We've been working on my general leg strength, so I've been squatting a lot. I did about 6 sets at this weight and then moved on to snatches. For snatching, I also worked up to 80%, around 50 kilos or 110 pounds. So I typically work out 3 to 4 days a week and usually spend anywhere from 1 to 3 hours at the gym. This includes warming up, lifting, accessory work, and sometimes stretching right after, which doesn't always happen. Usually it's once I get home, but sometimes I do. Last thing for today was clean and jerk. I worked up to around 83%, which is about 64 kilos or 140 pounds. Cleans just have not been feeling great for me lately. That's really all I have to say about that. I did not have time at the gym to do accessory work this day. Even though this is my first day of the week based on my program, this is actually my 3rd day in a row of lifting, so I was pretty sore. I work 12-hour shifts, 3 days a week, so the 4 other days that I'm off, I'm lifting. My schedule changes week to week, so I just happened to have 4 days off in a row over a weekend. So my 2 weeks were kind of merged and rolled over into the next. Alright, day 2. Like I was just saying, this is technically my 4th day in a row of lifting. This is pretty rare for me. Usually my schedule has me working a day or two in between so I can rest, even though my work days don't ever feel like rest days. We are getting right into it with snatches. This is a heavier snatch day, working all the way up to 88% with a snatch pull plus snatch complex. We're going all the way up to 125 pounds or 57 kilos. Next was a low hang snatch pull at 80%. This is 52 kilos or 115 pounds. I'm not a huge fan of pulls because they hurt my thumbs, but I get why we need them. Moving on. The last lift I did was a deadlift from a deficit. This was something I had to skip from last week, so I'm adding it to this day. This was about 70% of my one rep max, I think. I don't actually know what my true one rep max deadlift is anymore. It's been about 5 years since I've tested it. I have had my ups and downs with lifting over the years, so at the beginning of last year, I was lifting around 5 to 12% less than I am lifting now in all of my lifts. Yes, I did do the math for that, and by that logic, my current one rep max from my deadlift could be anywhere from 220 pounds to 235 pounds. However, my old one rep max was 245 pounds. Lately, I've been feeling strong enough to just go off that 245 pounds, and yeah, it's been working out great from there. Now on to some fun stuff, some accessory work. I was feeling good and energized today, so I did do accessory work from the day before that I did not get to, and the stuff that I had planned for this day. I started off with 5 box jumps that I increased in height each set. Once I finished the 5 box jumps, I supersetted these with 10 dumbbell bent over rows each arm. Why I increased the height each set for the box jumps was more just me testing my limits and seeing what I could do. I don't think it was actually necessary for what they were intended for to increase the height. For this last set of box jumps, I will admit I was pretty intimidated. I knew I could do it, but I've hurt myself on box jumps before. My shins are scarred as proof. I once missed the box and hit my shin so hard they were sensitive to the touch for about 2 weeks, and I couldn't mentally do a box jump for months. Once I was done with the box jumps and the bent over rows, I moved on to more upper body stuff. I did a superset of 12 banded tricep extensions with 12 concentrated curls on each arm. The last superset of the day was some core stuff. I don't really know what these are called, I just call them plank dumbbell side pulls, and I supersetted that with dead bugs. I did 20 each. I've been trying to focus on more core exercises each week, and to be honest, just these two movements alone had my abs burning. I started off with some back squats up to 80%, so about 80 kilograms or 176 pounds. Squatting felt pretty good this day, and as of me editing, I have actually added 5 kilograms or about 10 pounds to my back squat since starting this cycle. These were not the best. I am an overthinker, especially when I get cued to change something. Sometimes it clicks right away, and sometimes it takes me a while to figure out how to move my body in the way that it needs to. I just remind myself to be patient and keep working.
For accessory, I did some rows and some unilateral farmer's carries, and those I did not film. Just the rows. Last day, day 4. We start off once again with more squats. Box front squats up to 80%, so 75 kilos, about 165 pounds. After I finished the front squats, we moved on to clean deadlifts plus a clean, up to 88%. This was about 150 pounds or 68 kilos, and I was tired and these felt very heavy. Finish my lifting with some low hang clean pulls. Last thing on my list for the week was handstand walks. I love these so much and I wish I could do these every day, but I really only do them once a week now. And finally, for my weekly cardio, a 5-minute row. I rode about 1,000 meters in this 5-minute time. All right, that is my full week of workouts and lifting. I hope you enjoyed this video. I'm obviously always lifting, so if you like these videos, then I can always make more. Give this video a thumbs up if you liked it, and don't forget to subscribe and click the notification bell so you can be up to date with my lifting journey and all the other videos that I post.